Hi everyone, my name is Emily, and you may have seen me going around Portland like this. As you can probably imagine, I get a lot of questions and comments. You go, girl! Did you make that rig? Is that difficult? What's your phone number? I'm gonna answer some of those questions for you today, so that hopefully you'll wanna try riding a bicycle with a stand-up paddleboard too. So first of all, how does the setup work? No, I did not make this myself. This is a rig that I purchased from a website called storeyourboard.com, and the rack itself is made by a company called Moved by Bikes. The way it works is you have these two pieces that attach to the front and the back of your bike, and they're pretty easy to install. I am not an expert bike mechanic by any means, and it took me under an hour to just put those on there. Once you have those attachments on the front and the back, it's pretty simple. You just stick these holder pieces in, then you can place the board in, and gravity does most of the work. I don't use an additional fastener or bungee or anything. You might want to, and I'll wedge the paddle in between the board and the rack to just give it some extra stability, because if the board starts wobbling, you might wobble on your bike a little bit, and that's not the most comfortable. People want to know, how did I choose this rack? There are some options that will trail the board behind your bike, but to me that didn't feel as safe, and I wouldn't want to have to worry about having an 11 and a half foot piece of equipment trailing me and potentially getting hit by something. So I love this rack because it just puts the board right in line with my bike. Another question I get, do you need a special type of bike? I don't think so, but the thing that you have to be careful about is the clearance between the edge of the handlebars and the board, because if your handlebars are hitting the board, you're not going to be able to turn. What about the paddleboard? The paddleboard that I have is really great. It's the Newport model from Stand On Liquid. It's inflatable. It's 11 and a half feet long. It's 5 inches thick, and it's 24 pounds. For reference, I'm just under 5'8", and my weight is somewhere between 100 pounds and 150 pounds, and I feel that I can balance just fine with the 24 pounds of weight. If you're shopping for a board, I highly recommend looking into the inflatable options. I'm posting a link that will give you some information on construction methods, because there are some cheaper boards that you can get that ultimately like aren't gonna be rigid enough to stand on, or maybe they're gonna be heavier or thicker. And anyway, it's just good to know what you're getting yourself into. So people always wanna know, is this difficult to ride? Not really. Once you get moving, you're kind of doing it. You have to lean a little bit to one side, but not an extreme amount. I've had a couple spills, but only a couple, and it was just when I was first getting into it. And they were both when I was stopped. One was when I was getting on my bike, and one was when I was stopping at an intersection. And I think that's just the more difficult time to balance, actually. But Emily, what if there is a gust of wind? It'll totally tip you over. Actually, I've ridden this bike with my paddleboard in windy conditions, and it's not the most comfortable, but it's not that bad. I also get asked, where do I bike with my paddleboard, and what kind of distances do I cover? So I have a couple options. One is the Hawthorne Swim Dock, which is about a mile and a half from my place. Another great spot is Selwood Riverfront Park. And that's about 5 miles from my place, and I take the Springwater Corridor Trail out there, and it's lovely. Now I'll leave you with this one last bit, a little bit of advice, I guess. I hear from a lot of people like, oh my gosh, that's so cool, but I'm not strong enough to do that, or I'm not in good enough shape, something like that. And I'm just here to say that I think stand-up paddleboarding can be for almost anybody. And I think that riding your bike with a stand-up paddleboard could be for just about anybody who's fairly comfortable on a bicycle. So I hope I answered some of your burning questions for now. If you have any more, please leave them in the comments. Or if you decide to try this out on your own and you're inspired, I would love to hear from you. So please comment. And thank you so much. And I hope to see you all out on the water.